Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan selamat pagi tuan-tuan dan puan-puan yang dikasihi sekalian. Today I would like to explain about the hypothesis testing. There are simple method to understand about what is the hypothesis testing. So before we begin, let us recap a little bit about the statistical concept. We have two type of statistics. The first one we call it as a descriptive statistics, and then the second one will be the inferential statistics. So today we have been covering the inferential statistics in the nutshells. So as we learned yesterday, we got the data that already been tabulated normally. We got also data that is not tabulated normally. And then as you know, the inferential statistics under your syllabus will be covering two important things. The first one is hypothesis to measure differences. And then another one, inferential statistic, measure the relationship. Okay, so the relationship actually being divided into two is either correlation using the numerical data, and then you are going to learn also about association. So association will be covering using the chi-square, which is indicated as the non-numerical data, or we call it as a categorical data. So in the normal and not normal distributions, there are a few different types of differences test and also relationship test. It's depend on the following details. First one, it's depend on the SM, scale of measurement, whether it is a nominal, ordinal, interval and ratio. And then the second one is depends on the tabulation. And then the third one is depend on the group that we want to do. Okay, let us go in the quick manner about all these things. So I'm constructing a table actually, or this graphical overview to explain to you about differences test. So we're talking about differences test first, okay? So in the differences test, we got a following group. So N is actually a group. So we got one group, we got two group, or we call it as a two independence group. Independence group means that they are differ to each other, means that we got male and female, for example. And then we got more than two groups, which is also independent to each other. And then this one is actually can be assumed as following details. Example, races. We got Malay, Chinese, Indian. So all these things is actually more than two groups. And then the last but not least, we got the differences in terms of two times, okay? Two times, whereby we measure the pre and we measure the post. Usually, we are going to use this one under the experimental condition. Okay, so we got the differences test. So all these differences test that you need to understand in this statistical analysis. So the first one, one group. If your data is normal, therefore, you are going to use the one sample t-test. So this is the theoretical part. Okay, if you're comparing two independence group with one DV, so this is our DV, our numerical DV that is normally tabulated, example will be knowledge. So we know already yesterday I'm talking about the knowledge about statistics, right? So I would like to compare the knowledge with the knowledge among ILKKM students, for example, with a certain standards. So I'm usually called upon standards as a measurement of a certain values. So when you are comparing a group of people with a certain numbers, a certain standard, therefore we are going to use the one sample t-test. If you are trying to make a comparison of the knowledge between two independence groups, example, I would like to measure the knowledge of statistics among male and female, therefore I would like to see whether my data is normal or not normal. If my data is normally tabulated, therefore I would like to use the independent sample t-test. Okay, this is the summary actually. Alright, so if my data is normally tabulated and it is a numerical DV, knowledge for example, and I would like to compare between male and female, therefore I would like to use the independent sample t-test. And then if I would like to compare more than two groups, for example, Malay, Chinese and Indian, therefore I would like to use the ANOVA. ANOVA stands for Analysis of Variance. And if my data is normally tabulated and I would like to compare between pre and post, before and after, January compared with the December, before class, after class, and my DB is the knowledge and their data is tabulated normally, I will be using the PET sample t-test. PET sample t-test. So this is the example of what we call it as parametric analysis. Okay, so we are going to conduct the parametric analysis when our numerical DV are tabulated normally. What about if your data is not tabulated normally? We got the another option, we call it as a non-parametric. So non-parametric also distinguish with a different kind of set of data analysis. So the first one, for one group, when you want to compare with certain standards, therefore we are going to use the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test, or we call it as a normality test lah. We are going to compare those data with a certain condition. I will going to cover this one later on. If you are trying to compare between two independent group, let's say male and female, and your knowledge as your DV is not tabulated normally, they got a certain extreme values and then there are certain outliers, therefore you have to use the options of non-parametric data, a non-parametric analysis named as Mann-Whitney test. So another one will be if you're trying to compare between three groups, and these three groups are actually their numerical DV, dependent variables, are not tabulated normally. Therefore, you are going to use the non-parametric analysis named as Kruskal-Wallis. And if you are trying to compare between pre and post, and your data of DV is not tabulated normally, example in this thing is knowledge. Therefore, you have to use the non-parametric analysis named as Wilcoxon-Rank-Sum test. Okay, so that's conclude everything about our story this morning when we talk about the inferential statistics, especially in determining the differences of DV between certain group, between a certain group. So you got here normally tabulated data and not normally tabulated data. We got our DV knowledge, and then we got also our group, whether our group is one group, two groups, or more than two groups. And then we got also another condition, we call it as a differences of time. Therefore, if your data is normal, this is the test that you are will be using. If your data is not normal, therefore you are going to use all this kind of alternative approach. Okay, so let us recap. If you are trying to find differences of your DV according to the different group, therefore you have a certain condition. If the group is actually one group, you are trying to compare that one group, example male and female as a one group, you compare with the standard of the ILKKM knowledge of statistics, then that test is actually is one sample t-test. If you're trying to compare between two independent group, we are going to use the independent sample t-test. If you are trying to compare more than two groups, you are going to use the ANOVA, analysis of variance. If you are trying to compare between two times of the similar person, example Ahmad. Ahmad is a male, January, and then you want to compare the Ahmad also during July after the final exam. So you are trying to measure before and after two times, same person, Ahmad. You are going to use the PET sample t-test. All these one sample, independent sample, ANOVA, PET sample are called as parametric analysis if your data meeting the assumptions of normality. However, if your data is not normal, you have to use the another alternative approach. We call it as the non-parametric analysis. When you want to compare to one group, you are conducting the Kruskal-Wallis test. You are going to use the Kolmogorov-Smirnov normality test, or else, which I will talk this one later. And then if you are trying to compare between two independent groups, you are going to use the Mann-Whitney-Usek test. If you are trying to compare more than two groups and your data is not normal, therefore you are going to use the Kruskal-Wallis. And then when you want to compare between two groups and then that group is also not normally distributed, you are going to use the Wilcoxon-Rank-Sum test. Okay, that's end our discussion today about the differences test. So remember, in a nutshell, to understand the inferential statistics, actually it's being divided into two. The first one is differences, and then the second one is a relationship. Okay, so we already explore the part of differences, and then we are going to learn about how the process will be in the next slide or in the next discussion. And then we are also going to learn about relationship, where we measure the relatedness between variable IV and also DB. With that, thank you very much, and enjoy watching another video. See you again. Assalamualaikum and bye-bye.